Hey folks, welcome back to another episode of Cooking at Home. Today we'll be making some badass tacos, but we'll be doing it two ways. One will be a steak taco with some chimichurri sauce, and in this case, as you can see here in slow-mo, is our fish taco with some avocado crema. Now, of course, for a steak taco, you're gonna need some steak. So we got some bavette here. It's very tender. It's very similar to the flank steak, but basically what we're gonna do with the cut of meat is let it get to room temperature, marinate in our chimichurri, and then sear it off. So you're gonna wanna do that in advance, give it a few minutes, but the fish, in our case, obviously, well, we needed a white fish. So we went with some monkfish here. It has a bit more of a firm texture, but you can really use kind of whatever white fish you want. That could be bassa fillets, tilapia. I recommend cod as an alternative, but whatever's available at your fishmonger or at the market, just grab that and whatever looks good, you know? So that's kind of what you need. To flavor our fish, we're gonna use some ancho powder. Again, this is kind of, you can replace with chipotle or paprika or some mix. I just went with ancho because again, I had it and I actually like the taste. It's kind of mild, not as spicy, which goes well with a fish like monkfish. So with the fish, you wanna obviously, well, take a look at it, make sure there's no pin bones, but also we're gonna cut it in half. It's a bit of a big piece. Then once we've done that, we're gonna add some salt, of course, to season and some pepper. And finally, some of that delicious ancho powder I was talking about. Now, make sure you season this pretty thoroughly, guys. You wanna have it well seasoned and covered just so you can make sure that you're not missing any parts. And that's really all it is, guys. Very simple, very straightforward. I promise you though, it will be delicious. And don't be afraid to add other spices to this if you so choose. With our proteins out of the way, let's just dive into all the ingredients we're gonna need. Now, obviously, we're gonna need some garlic. Always need garlic. Chimichurri is gonna use about 4 cloves. Again, we'll sort of blitz that up and show it to you. You'll also want a spicy pepper. In this case, we're using a little Thai pepper, but just, you know, you can use anything that you like, jalapeno, etc. Just find a pepper that kind of hits you right. So to that, we'll be adding some limes, guys. You know, this will be both in our sauce, but also just particular avocado crema sauce, I should say, and also on top of the tacos themselves. You'll want a bundle of herbs. In this case, we're gonna use 3 herbs. We're gonna use some cilantro, which you have to, you know, smack to make sure it's fresh. But some cilantro is probably the base of what you'll be using. You'll also want to use some parsley. Again, you won't use as much parsley, but I recommend a mix. So parsley, some cilantro, and of course, some basil. Again, you won't use a ton of basil or parsley. The base of this sort of green mix for the chimichurri will be your cilantro. Now, of course, you can't have avocado crema without avocados. So grab yourself 2 nice avocados that are ready to go, cut those into those, and we'll be smashing those and mix them with some mayonnaise. Again, you can use any mayonnaise you like, but something that has full fat or half fat. In this case, I'm using half fat just because we're using avocados too. Now, we will be making some quick pickled onions. You'll need some vinegar, of course, some salt, some honey, maybe some sugar, and of course, you know, a red onion. So grab yourself some vinegar and a red onion. You don't have to do this step if you don't want, but I think this goes really well on top of these kinds of tacos. They're fresh, add some brightness, and I highly recommend it. Now, I don't know about you, but I usually like to have some red cabbage on my fish tacos and tacos generally, so grab yourself some red cabbage. If you don't like it, you can replace it with something else, but make sure it's nice and firm and ripe and ready to go. To that, we're gonna add a roasted poblano. Now, these you can find or replace with just about any pepper that you like, but poblanos go really well. You just char them up and they're good to go. Optionally, we're gonna add some feta. Now, normally you might use cotija cheese. I couldn't find any. Feta is readily available, salty, has the same color, similar texture. So I used feta. Don't worry, I didn't forget. You're gonna wanna make yourself a pineapple salsa as well. So get yourself a fresh pineapple. Wanna add to your salsa, of course, a bit of onion, which we're gonna go here with here. It's just a simple, just white onion or yellow onion, whatever's kind of a neutral-ish flavor. I think there's a yellow onion here, so we're gonna use that. So it's gonna be hard to make tacos without the shells. So grab yourself some flour tortillas. You'll also wanna grab some corn tortillas. I recommend the flour tortillas for the fish and the corn tortillas for the steak. Now, guys, with that out of the way, we're gonna quickly show you how to make the sauces. We'll start with the chimichurri. Let's go. So for our chimichurri sauce, we're gonna start with our garlic and smash up. We're gonna use about 4 cloves. We're gonna use 1 spicy pepper and a bunch of cilantro. And this will all be going into the blender, but you're still gonna wanna chop everything up. So grab your garlic, chop it up nice and fine, just pass through it once or twice, and then do the same with your spicy pepper, and of course the same with your cilantro. With that done, you're gonna add your cilantro, garlic, and your Thai pepper to the blender. Now, I would recommend that you use a food processor if you have one, because you get a bit of a coarser cut on everything, which is kind of what you want with chimichurri. But in this case, we have a little magic bullet, so that's what we're gonna use. Now, before you blitz everything up, realize that you forgot some basil, so we're gonna cut that up and put that in there, and then we're gonna go blitz it all up until you realize that you also forgot to put in onion. So finely dice an onion, and not super fine, but finely dice, and put that in there as well. We're using about 1/2 onion here. Put that into your chimichurri as well, and you'll have some leftovers for later. You put about a quarter of the onion into your chimichurri and you'll reserve the rest for just for topping directly onto your tacos. To that, we'll finally add a little bit of vinegar and a good glug of olive oil, about a half a cup of olive oil. I'll take one good last look at this before we turn it into its final version right here. And with that done, and it is delicious, by the way, guys, we're going to put this on our steak as a marinade. So you're going to grab your steak, you're going to grab your finished chimichurri, and you're just going to pour it over top and begin the marinating process. This will probably take about, well, anywhere from an hour, ideally, to more in the 5 hour range. But in this case, I think I only did it for about 2 hours before searing. But just make sure you cover it well with the chimichurri and you should be fine. Now, with that done, we're going to reserve the remaining chimichurri as a sauce that we can then put directly onto our tacos, guys. Everything is kind of multi-purpose here, and I recommend that you make enough to have extras. So with that done, we're going to move to our avocado crema. And in this case, well, you're going to need your avocados and they look delicious. So we're happy about that. I'm going to grab the rest of our ingredients, which includes, of course, some basil, some parsley, and some cilantro, of course. And we're going to take all our herbs together, roll them up, and just give them a quick chop. Guys, the reason you want all these herbs, again, you can pick the ones you like, but for me, the idea with the avocado crema is it's very herbaceous. There's a lot of just kind of flavor in there. So chopped up, you're going to add that into your blender. Again, guys, ideally, you would have, well, like I said, a food processor, but that's all right. We'll add our two avocados here. And again, you could add more avocados, guys. You could add less, depending on how many people, but you kind of want some extra sauce because it is very tasty. Now, don't forget your lime, which I almost did. Add your lime, add about a full lime worth of juice, depending on how juicy it is. And of course, you're going to add some mayo. About a half a cup of mayo will do. You're just looking to add some creaminess to this mix. Now, once you put those ingredients into your blender, you should have something like this. I promise you, it is delicious as is, but we got to add some salt and of course some pepper. Give that a quick mix and you're good to go. So there you go, guys, we have our chimichurri finished. This is what we've left in reserve for our tacos, and of course we have our avocado crema as well. You'll want extra because, you know, you're gonna keep eating it. All right, guys, to make quick pickled onions, well, you're gonna need your onion and you're gonna need to cut it into pretty thin slices. Again, you can go coarser here if you want, but I recommend something fairly thin. When you're done slicing, you're gonna add that to your pot and you're gonna add some vinegar and then some water. Now you're going to do one part vinegar to one part water, and it should be just enough to cover everything. Now with that done, you're going to add some salt to season, and you're going to want to add some sugar, or in this case, some honey. And with that added, we're just going to stir everything together, and we're going to go right to the stove. On the stove, guys, you're literally just going to bring this to the boil, and you're done. Go back to our chopping board, and we're going to start to get our pineapple salsa going. So, of course, you're going to need your pineapple, which you're going to have to top and tail, guys. If you've never kind of worked with pineapple, it's pretty easy to work with. Basically, you're just going to take the top and bottom off, cut off all the excess on the sides, and then watch out for the core in the middle. Yes, that's the core, that hard part in the middle. So you're going to cut around the core and cut everything into cubes. Now, I know what you're thinking. Yes, these cubes are far too big for a taco. Well, that's for good reason, because these are not taco pineapple cubes. These are our eaten cubes, and we're going to be saving these for later because who doesn't like fresh pineapple in the morning? So with that out of the way, we're actually going to cut our actual pineapple slices here. And so, guys, we're going to go really quite small here. You want very fine dice on the pineapple. As you can see, these chunks look like they're appropriate size for a taco. Now to that pineapple, we're going to add our diced onion and some herbs, a bit of lime and some salt, and that's it. So last but not least, we're going to cut up our delicious red cabbage. Now you could use any cabbage you want. You could use anything that's sort of crunchy. You could pickle it. I don't know. You decide. But basically you want a thinly sliced red cabbage or something crunchy on top. And you're going to add that on top of your tacos directly. Now I personally like this on my fish tacos, but it kind of ends up on both. So there you go, guys. Chopped out nice and thin like that. And you're off to the races. Finally, we're going to take our poblano pepper, put it in a cast iron pan, and while we're waiting for that, we're going to think about that thing we did 10 years ago, and then we're going to come back and have a beautifully charred, wonderful poblano pepper. Now, with that out of the way, guys, we're going to highlight all the ingredients we've currently made, including the charred poblano, the red cabbage, our pineapple salsa, some pickled onions, some white onion, some feta cheese, our sort of cilantro parsley basil mix, our chimichurri, and of course, our avocado crema. Now with everything beautifully lit out, you're gonna take your requisite Instagram photo. There we go. We're moving on to our searing of our steak, which as you can see, very hot pan. This is what you want. Don't mind the smoke, guys. I don't have a good hood, but you'll get something like this. And I promise you, no, nothing there is burnt. It is very much charred and delicious. So you're gonna let that go for about 4 or 5 minutes per side. You can even pick this up and just cook it on the other ends here, but basically you'll end up with a delicious, well-cooked piece of meat that you're going to let rest for about 10 minutes. Once rested, you can cut into it, and as I said, it may look a little burnt on the outside, but I promise you it is all flavor, and look how goddamn delicious that looks. So you're going to slice your meat into, well, manageable pieces for a taco. Again, you can do thinner, thicker, doesn't really matter. You can even do cubes. I recommend these slices going against the grain, similar to what you do with flank steak, and you'll have delicious meat, I promise. So with the steak done, we're going to go back to the stove. We're going to put some oil down for our fish in a non-stick pan, and we're just going to lay it down gently. In this case, we're going to put the thicker piece down first, as you can see. Just let it get some more cook time on it. Now, once that's kind of seared up on one side, you should have a nice kind of darkened golden brown color. We'll let the kind of pan and the oil do the work. And then so we flipped it, we'll add the smaller piece. Now, obviously, if you had more even pieces, you wouldn't have to do this, but you should basically be cooking this for about total of about 7 minutes per piece. Once those are done, you're going to take it off the heat before moving over to our cutting board to, of course, slice into this. Now, make sure you let this rest for about, again, 5 to 6 minutes, and you should see how this kind of fish holds together very nicely. It has more of a texture like lobster tail as opposed to your fish that really flakes and fall apart, but that's sort of the beauty of monkfish. Gently place your taco shells in the cast iron pan before just giving a quick little sear and flipping them till you have a nice golden brown color. Once done, you're going to move to a plate and begin assembling. In this case, we're going to start with a delicious steak taco. Guys, you could literally just eat that and be happy, but we're going to add some of our white onion, some of our charred poblano, a nice spoonful of that really, really delicious chimichurri sauce. Some fresh herbs that we have left over, and a pinch or two of our feta cheese. Now, you can really start to see the contrast in colors, and it just begins to kind of look really pretty. To that, we're going to add a nice fresh squeeze of lime, and at the last minute, we're going to decide to add some avocado crema, because who doesn't like avocado crema? Now, with everything put together, it is time to roll that bad boy up and dig in. I'm sorry you guys have to watch me eat this, guys, but I have to tell you, it was really delicious. All the flavors, all the textures, all the work in the prep was really worth it, and highly recommend you just give this one a shot if you want to have an upgraded taco. And speaking of tacos, we didn't forget about our fish taco, so we're going to go back to the stove and put on a flour tortilla and just char it up again like the other one. Once we're done with that, we're going to assemble. Now in this case, we're going to start with avocado crema, spread that around. That will add about 3 little medallions of our monkfish, a couple spoonfuls or forkfuls in this case of our pineapple salsa, which again adds a ton of brightness, some red cabbage on top, a little serving of our pickled onions, which guys, these were delicious on these tacos, I have to say, really a high point on them. Some herbs, and of course, we're gonna add finally a bit of our cheese. And of course, don't forget a little squeeze of lime, because I think it goes a long way. All right, folks, so here it is, our final product in all its glory. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and yes, I will be eating this taco, of course. But do tune in, guys, in the future for some more cooking videos and some other things that we do. We do all kinds of things on this channel. We have a lot of fun. Hope you guys are enjoying the videos. Let me know in the comments down below if there's anything else you'd like to see. But that'll do it for us, guys. Till next time, thanks so much for tuning in. We'll see you soon.